cough a little bit, it's okay. If you sneeze a little bit, it's okay. Far away.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Thank you for having me, though. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, no, it is. It's kind of great. So, I was also wondering, because with the entire lineage of the family that you come from, you know,
okay,
with basically the animation background, how has really helped you, you know, in shaping up your life?
Well, frankly, I've been very fortunate because I've grown up in an environment that fostered this kind of, visual kind of literacy, as it's called, right?
Okay.
So the environment that I was brought up in kind of fostered that visual literacy. And therefore, you know, ever since I was born, I think I was exposed to stories, storytelling, the visual arts, you know, architecture, design, everything related to film and animation. I was brought up in that environment. So I was brought up, you know, around music, around paintings, around films, around books. So I kind of had a very good childhood that way, you know, that kind of, shaped me to become who I am, you know. So that's how it actually really happened, because I think...
How do people, like, let's say, basically, because I've read that Tim Burton or... You know, basically, Wes Anderson, Spielberg, they all have kind of shaped some part of your life, you know. And so, the reason I'm asking is because I'm telling my students that, you know, it's great to have some kind of a role models in life, you know, in some sense. You know, people who,
yeah.
So you can largely learn from them. You
Absolutely.
And someday, if they're alive, you can actually go and meet them, you know. So,
Absolutely.
So generally, just to hear from you that how these people have, you know, helped you shape your thoughts, your ideas.
So the thing is that, most filmmakers in India really, they don't, I really feel that they lack a visual sense, right? So they focus a lot on the narrative and a lot of focus is paid to the narrative. But there's very, very little focus paid to the visuals, right? Getting the composition right, getting the lighting right, getting staging right, getting choreography right, getting... knowing how to jamao the shot, you know, really knowing how to frame the shot in a way that it looks visually appealing. So that sense is not there, and sense of color palette, sense of, you know, costumes and sense of production design, that sense is still lacking in India, because most filmmakers, when they go to an Indian film institute like an FTI or SRFTI or Whistling Woods, these institutes focus, the primary focus is documentary. Visual understanding. Now with filmmakers like Tim Burton and Wes Anderson, these two filmmakers have a very good style. You know, you can by watching the film itself, you know that it, you know, they've got their signature all over it. Because, you know, you see the frame, you see the kind of characters that they have, the way the characters are designed, the way they, even the characters' performances are somewhat consistent across their films. So you know that it's a Tim Burton film, you know, immediately as you watch it. Or you know it's a Wes Anderson as you watch it. And that's really important, because, you know, for every filmmaker must have a sort of a signature all over their, or not just a filmmaker, in fact, any artist, any architect, any kind of designer must be, have a style of their own kind of aesthetic quality, right? Which kind of tells the audience that, oh, look, this is my work and nobody else can do work like this anywhere else.
So currently we have kind of given 2-3 exercises, you know, where the students are supposed to basically take one of the graphic designers and that person should become a kind of a role model. The current exercise is looking at artists, you know, from different kind of an art movement, and they should basically look at the artist as one of the role models, you know. So the idea is to basically also kind of give them a sense of what is the quality when it comes to visuals, you know.
Correct.
Because I completely agree with you that visual sense is something which you basically gain over a period of time, as in, you know, you know, ability of aesthetics cannot be taught by books or by anything. It purely is by the mere exposure, you know. It's like music, you know, you can basically listen, you're part of that. That's the only way you learn to understand
Absolutely.
And appreciate music, you know.
Absolutely.
So I'm hoping that you know, your session will kind of help, you know, gear the students towards the idea of visual world, you know, at this point.
Yeah, absolutely. I hope so too. In fact, I wanted to actually open it up and ask all of you guys, because we have only an hour. And the thing with filmmaking is that filmmaking is not, you know, has several specializations within it. So you have different departments, right? You have cinematography, you have screenwriting, you have direction, you have production, you have production design or art direction, you have costumes, you have, there are so many facets to making a film, right? There's music, there's sound, there are so many facets. So I don't know how much I'll, you know, it'll be very difficult for you, for even me to give a broad brushstroke in 1 hour. But I would like to open it up to you guys. What would you all like me to focus on? Would you like me to focus on the visual language, or would you like me to focus on the writing of films?
Somebody can answer.
Yeah, you guys can answer. Just don't hesitate. Yeah. I'm very chill. Don't worry.
Yeah.
So, Aryan, you want to add something?
I think visual language.
Okay. Anybody else? You guys can even, if you're uncomfortable, you can even write it in the chat box. I'm okay with that. Just write V for visual language and W for writing. So you have a choice here. V or W. Quickly, guys. We don't have much time.
Yeah, I think visual language would be great to know.
Yeah, visual language would be really great.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll go ahead and do that then. So have you guys watched the three films that I suggested as a watch list? Neighbors, Choros, and Sizzle, which is The Wind. I think these three films personally are my favorite films because they have shaped my understanding of cinema. These are the films that I watched when I was really young, and they have inspired me in my films and the films that I've made. Right, Neighbors inspired a film called Illusion for Dummies, which is a film that has by far my most popular kind of work, which has got me maximum amount of accolades. A Sizzle is a film that is absolutely brilliant because I've never heard of an Indian film or even a foreign film that has such great understanding of music. Right, log jo hai jo फिल्म बनाते हैं उनको म्यूजिक सेंस भी हमारे एटलीस्ट हमारे कंट्री में मुझे देयर आर वेरी फ्यू फिल्म मेकर्स हु हैव दैट सेंस ऑफ म्यूजिक राइट एंड दिस आई थिंक दिस इज अ मास्टरपीस बिकॉज़ यू नो इट रियली टेक्स गट्स टू क्रिएट म्यूजिक लाइक दैट एंड ऑफ कोर्स चोरोज इज अगेन अ फिल्म दैट इंस्पायर्ड माय लेटेस्ट वर्क व्हिच इज नॉट रिलीज्ड येट इट्स अ फिल्म कॉल्ड डाली व्हिच आई शॉट अबाउट last year, and it took me really long to make because it's a live action animation combination film, right? Cool. So what I will do is then, since you guys want to know more about the visual language and you want me to primarily focus on that, I will start by showing you a short film that I made. I don't know, has anybody seen Religion for Dummies here? How many of you all have seen it? Everybody? Is anybody here who hasn't seen it? Anybody who hasn't seen it, then I'll show it. Okay, I think everybody has seen it then. Cool. So what I will do now is just take you through the process of making the film. Right, so I'm going to quickly just share my screen with you guys and just take you through a presentation that we made for the making of the film. Can you guys see my screen? Everybody can see my screen?
Yes, we can.
Okay, superb. Sounds good. Right, so I'm going to take you through the creative process of making of this film. Now, for those of you who, obviously, most of you have seen the film, like you said, this film was shot over 8 days, right? And there was massive amount of pre-production that went into the film. Primarily because we needed to do a lot of test shoots to get this right. Now, in the film, obviously, as you could see, there are these elaborate paintings or murals that are being painted as the background as the character moves along, in the frame, right? So we knew that when the character moves from point A to point B, in that many frames, that whole piece of art also has to be created. And it was done in a in stop motion, and you know, stop motion or pixelation as it's called, very similar to you know, what they did in Neighbors, which you saw, right? Now, so therefore there was a lot of storyboarding done, a lot of test shoots that were done, because like I said, from point A to point B, if there are 50 frames, in those 50 frames we needed to complete that whole mural, right? For example, so there were, I think, about 7,000 frames which were entirely hand painted, right? And there was a lot of visual planning that went into this film. First, it started off with getting the color palette right, right? Then getting the costumes right, then the production design right, getting a sense of obviously before the color palette, doing extensive research, right? Because the our primary visual references were Gurmeet Ram Rahim Singh and Radhe Ma, and you know, all these pretentious godmen who are very farcical in their ways and very megalomaniacal, and they have made religion into a business. So that was our reference, right? We knew that we wanted to take inspiration from what they really do, and their, you know, exuberance in the kind of costumes that they wear and their colors and all that glitz and glam that they kind of portray, and take reference from that and kind of make that into a film, and make that not just into a film, but make that into a mockumentary, which is, you guys know what a mockumentary is? Mockumentary is a satire, right? Which is a documentary, which is where you're making a mockery of a certain kind of system or a certain kind of world that you see, right? So yeah, that was primarily what we wanted to do. And this idea came to me while I was in the lift. In fact, I was going up in the lift, and suddenly I was reading this book called Dummy's Guide to Mathematics, right? So I said, okay, why not make a dummy's guide to religion, on how to start a religion? And usme maza aayega. I said, you know, we'll just have fun, we'll make this film. And I had seen, us time pe maine wo bhi dekha tha, Neighbors bhi dekha tha, aur ek 1974 Films Division film. In fact, you guys should watch it. So write the name, it's called Abid, A-B-I-D, Abid. It's a 1974 Films Division ka film hai. और उस टाइम पे जो फिल्म्स डिवीजन के जो फिल्म्स बनते थे ना, वो बड़े एक्सपेरिमेंटल होते थे. तो उन तरीके के जो फिल्म्स जो थे, वो उसी टाइम पे सब्सिडी मिलती थी उनपे, वो जो फिल्म्स उसी टाइम पे उन तरीके की फिल्म्स को सब्सिडी मिलती थी. आज के जमाने में वो ऐसे एक्सपेरिमेंटल फिल्म बनते ही नहीं है, फिल्म्स डिवीजन बना भी नहीं रही है कुछ फिल्म. तो दैट इज बेसिकली हाउ द सीड ऑफ दिस आइडिया रियली वॉज कंसीव्ड. And then obviously now I will take you through the entire creative process without yapping any longer. Yeah, so like I said, finding the concept, it started with finding the concept. Everybody can see my screen, right? Yeah. I'm seeing slides.
Yes.
Okay, sounds good. Okay, so it started with, now every film starts with there are four facets that every film starts with. It starts with a log line, a premise, a controlling idea, and a character sketch. Right now, a log line is basically your story in one line, right? What is your story in one line? What is the story of Lagan in one line? The story of Lagan in one line is, you have to explain the story of Lagan. I'm just making it up, I don't really know, but just from the top of my head, the story of Lagan is, in the log line of Lagan would be, in a one line without any full stops, is that a group of Indians challenge the British to a game of cricket, for them to kind of exempt them from paying a month, from paying a yearly lagan, right? That is what the story of Lagan is in one line, right? What is a premise? A premise is basically, it's a premise always is a question. What happens if is what your premise is, right? What happens if for Lagan, for example, what happens if a group of Indians challenge the British to a game of cricket for them to exempt them of paying their yearly lagan? What happens if? It's a question. Okay. And this is just rules of storytelling that I'm sharing with you guys. Okay. A controlling idea is obviously your controlling idea. What is your concept, right? So what is the concept of lagan? The concept of lagan is very simple. It's about how there are these villagers, Indian villagers, who are trying to going through a lot of struggles because of issues with rainfall, and you know, they want to be exempted from paying lagan. So your messaging also comes in through the controlling idea. What is the messaging of lagan? The messaging of Lagaan is very clear. The messaging of any other film, any good high concept film is very clear, right? And that has to come through in the controlling idea, right? Of course, there are lots of films that don't have controlling ideas also. So there are films that are just what I would call frivolous films, which I would call maybe a Rohit Shetty film or a Farah Khan film. I'm sorry if you guys like them, but I don't. So I will shit on them. But so there are lots of films that don't have controlling ideas, but most good films, I think, at least internationally, also have controlling ideas, and it's important to note those down as well. Now your character sketch, right? Your character sketch is basically, there are most films have either one protagonist, or they have one protagonist, one antagonist, two protagonists, or even three, there are buddy films, right? Buddy films like a Rock-On or a Dil Chahta Hai, which you have three protagonists in those cases, right? Or Kaipo Che. Will have three, those are buddy films, they will have three protagonists. So you write your character sketches for all three of them. What are their character arcs? What are the backstories? What are their motivations? What is at stake for them? Now, what is at stake is also very important, which is that what is it that really drives them in their life, and what is it one purpose that they have to achieve? And if they don't achieve that, then they will face huge loss in their life. So that is called what is at stake for them. Right, so there's motivation, there is what is at stake, there is backstory, there is a character arc or a character graph, as it's called. Right, so every character goes through a philosophical transformation across the journey of the story. Right, and that also comes in through the character sketch. So what are the changes that occur in all of our lives? We know that we've grown from being young to becoming more mature as we've grown older. Right, I know I believed a lot of things when I was younger, which I don't believe now. I had a lot of opinions when I was younger that I don't have opinions now. I have changed as a person. I've become better. I've become more informed. I've gained more knowledge. I've gone across the course of my life. Right. So everybody goes through that process. When they grow older, they change. So therefore, in the journey of any film, not just a film, in fact, in every scene, ideally, there should be a character graph. Right, so you guys should check out Dan Harnin's Story Circle. He will give you a sense of how story circles are, as in like, what is an ideal story? Right, where in every scene there is a character graph, and in every from beginning to end, there should be a larger character graph also, that a journey that the character must go through, a transformation rather that the character must go through. Are you guys following so far, or am I going too fast?
No, it's all right.
You're sure? If anybody is facing any difficulty, please let me know. Everybody's following, right?
Yes.
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 Okay. Cool. Okay. Now, once you've got all of those bases covered, which is your logline, premise, controlling idea, character sketch, what do you have next? You have your scheduling, which is a part of production. This is not so much into the visual language. This is just a part of a production process. Scheduling starts with obviously task, timeline, status. So this is a schedule that we had made in 2017 for the film. So in June we were to finalize the script and the concept art, then we were to finalize the team, storyboarding, location, etc. Okay, then that's me, by the way. This is me. Can you see me? This was one of the first few meetings that we had for the film, in fact, where we were trying to finalize the color palette for the film. So you have pastel colors and you have saturated colors. You decide what kind of color palette you're looking at. Now, obviously, we knew that we wanted them to be hyper-saturated, right? Because obviously, this whole idea of Godman is that they're pretentious. They're very pretentious. They're very, gaudy. So to speak, they're very gaudy, where they're very over the top. They're very gaudy. They're very, they're very over the top in a way that they're not classy enough. You know, they've just got these elements that they've put together to kind of attract eyeballs, but they've got no class to them. So that was the whole kind of, that was the brief that I had given my visual director. And I said, this is the zone I'm looking at, and I want a color palette to be designed. So this was one of the first few color palettes that they had designed. I think I rejected this, I don't remember. But this was what we had begun with. I remember this was the first thing that we had created for the film, what you see on top. Now referencing, right? Like I said, Norman Mecler is Neighbors, Pramod Pathy is Abid. We started with color palette and stylization referencing, set design referencing. Now these were some sketches that I had made. I was a kid then, so I was not such a great sketcher. I think I was 18 or 17, I don't remember. But yeah, these were some of the referencing, and I knew that we needed to pay tribute. Sorry, we needed to kind of not pay tribute. We needed to kind of make it look like they were that these were religious attires without kind of making any references to any specific religion, because we didn't want to make it into a communal narrative. The idea was to not take down any one particular religion, where you take down Christianity, Islam, or Hinduism. The idea was to just make a point about God-men. It is not about religion. It was about God-men and about their farcical methods. So what we did then was we needed to, obviously it had to look religious, the costume, but we couldn't make any reference to any specific religion, like I said. So, the religious symbol that we kind of locked in on was a fidget spinner, because us time pe wo fad tha na, sab log ghoom rahe the fidget spinner ke sath. So fir hame socha yaar, instead of taking any other religious, where you take a swastika or you take a whatever, we'll make a religious symbol into a fidget spinner, and usko hum ya to polka dot ya fidget spinner, ya we had also thought of some eyes. I'll show you some stuff that we decided for the, we were doing some referencing, some kind of concept art that we had made for the religious symbol, which will come ahead. I'll show you those also. So yeah, this was some of the stuff. Then these are the glasses, the referencing for the glasses. So we're taking out some references for kind of glasses that we want, because the glasses, if you remember the film, the glasses are, the glasses are flickering and changing. This was some of the concept art that we made. So by the way, nobody knows this. You guys are all architecture students, right? Are you all architecture students?
So they are all interior designers.
Interior designers, okay. Yeah. So I was also studying architecture, by the way. I was at Kamla Raheja in Mumbai. At the time I was making this film. So these are some of the sketches that I had made at that time. We thought of the kind of set we want, what is the kind of lighting, what, I don't even remember what all this was, in fact. How do we want to open the film? That was the opening shot, becomes very important for me in my process. So how do we want to open the film is something that we were kind of deliberating on. Then I think after that, yes, this is, I think, the most interesting of all the kind of concepts that we made. Of course, like I said, the religious symbol that we wanted to create had to look religious without paying any reference to any specific religion. तो रिलीजियस सिंबल का लुक क्या होगा वो बहुत बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट हो गया था हमारे लिए, और वो तो प्राइमरी फोकस उस पर ही था. इनिशियली जो कॉन्सेप्ट आउट बना रहे थे वो ही फिगर आउट करने के लिए बना रहे थे, तो अलग अलग हमने बनाया था. वी टुक डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ लुक्स एंड दिस दैट एंड द अदर, बट दिस वाज लुकिंग वेरी एलियन. एंड देन फाइनली वी सेड, अच्छा फॉरगेट ऑल ऑफ दिस, हम लोग फिजिक्स स्पिनर ही रखते. सो या एज यू कैन सी, दिस वाज सम ऑफ द डिजाइंस दैट वी हैड मेड एट दैट टाइम. Yeah. Are you guys finding this interesting or boring?
It's pretty interesting, actually.
Yeah.
Pakka? Not getting bored, na?
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Okay. Thank you. okay, cool. So I will move ahead then. So then this, we moved on to the storyboarding. I don't know why this image is pixelated, but anyway, I hope you guys can see. This was some of the initial storyboard. So we thought of some very bizarre things, in fact, like as you can see in the second panel on the right-hand side, on the left-hand side. There was some kind of, I don't remember actually, this was many years, 3-4 years ago, but whatever I remember, this was some supposed to be the lamp that becomes the sun. So the lamp ka hai. So we were just, it was just a flight of imagination. We were just stretching our imagination and seeing, achha, baad mein dekhenge kaise execute karna hai. Abhi hume sirf dream karna hai. Abhi sirf imagine karna hai ki, क्या चाहिए हमें, आइडियल लुक क्या रहेगा फिल्म का. तो फिर वी वर नॉट थिंकिंग अबाउट लिमिटेड बाय एनी काइंड ऑफ कंस्ट्रेंट्स ऑफ हाउ विल वी डू इट, हाउ विल वी एग्जीक्यूट इट. फर्स्ट इट ऑलवेज बिगिंस विद एन आइडिया दैट ये हमें बनाना है, फिर बाद में देखेंगे कि कैसे करते हैं कैसे बनाते हैं, वो हम पूछ पूछ के या ऑनलाइन देख के हम पता लगाएंगे कैसे करते हैं, अचीव कैसे करेंगे हमें, हम ये जो बनाना चाहते हैं. तो प्रोसेस ये मेरा पर्सनल प्रोसेस यही होता है कि आई डोंट रियली थिंक ऑफ द कंस्ट्रेंट्स, आई डोंट रियली थिंक ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ यू नो हाउ इज इट अचीव्ड और हाउ डू वी गेट टू मेकिंग दिस. आई यूजुअली जस्ट ड्रीम बिंदास, यू नो, खुल खुल के. आई जस्ट लेट माई सेल्फ फ्री एंड आई कम अप विद व्हाटएवर आइडियाज आई कैन एंड देन फिगर आउट लेटर हाउ इट इज टू बी डन. So, this was, of course, these were all rejected later. These were storyboards that were the first preliminary storyboards that we made. वो बाद में हमने मैंने काफी changes किए थे. But just for you to get a sense of how storyboarding is done, you know, it's really rough, quick sketches. थोड़ा बहुत उसको watercolor से हमने paint भी किया था just to give some sense of the visuals. But primarily like very rough, you know, 10 minute के अंदर पूरा एक page like fill up the whole goddamn page, that kind of thing. Some more stuff. मुझे याद भी नहीं है ये सब क्या था. Then some more, you know, this again the kind of religious symbols you can see on the left hand side, and then the religious symbol we thought, you know, will be stuck to his forehead. And you know, we thought, you know, like in the way you saw in neighbors also, you know, they're not walking or they're not kind of sliding across the frame. Some, you know, they're gliding. Where there's one foot at the back, you know, where they're lifting one foot and they're gliding, or they're sliding on the floor, you know, their chest is on the floor and they're sliding, and sometimes their feet are up in the air and they're moving, and you know, you have that very interesting staccato music. So I was actually thinking in the music form also, you know, I was thinking about the music also, I was thinking about the pace, I was thinking about pauses kahan rahenge, kya rahega, edit pattern kya rahega. Wo hazaar cheeze main matlab pura hi film maine dimag mein visualize karke rakha tha ki aise dikhega film mein pura ye. Because this kind of film cannot be made if you don't have it clear in your mind like kya banana chahte ho. You cannot make this film if it's not clear in your mind. It has to be, you have to be able to see the whole film in your eye, in your mind and in your eye. You must be able to, the drama always plays out in the head. The drama for any film always plays out in the head. That's very critical to note. That wo drama dimag mein hona chahiye ki kya hone wala hai, kya dikhne wala hai screen pe. And especially for this kind of film, because इस तरीके का जो film है ना, वो music पे भी काफी dependent है. The music of the film also is very interesting. I went through three, four music composers to arrive at this music. We had got an Italian composer, जिसको this by the way this year he got an Oscar. But at that time he composed the music for this film, and he didn't obviously. I wanted that little Indian kind of you know vibe to it, and he didn't. He wasn't obviously very familiar with the kind of Indian instrumentation and that we needed for the film. So what he composed was really off the mark. But anyway, he then composed the music for my last film and then Dali also. So I worked with him again. Two of my films, he's composed the music after that. Then again, some more storyboarding. More sketches. Basically, he hypnotizes them and he becomes, so that snake scene, right, where he's playing the basuri and they are moving in that circle around him and wo bada ban raha hai, set piche pe ban raha hai, whatever. That was supposed to be him hypnotizing them and they're, yeah, so you can see that snake wala scene on the right hand side. Can you see it? Wait, I'll just highlight it. This. Can you guys see?
Yes.
See it? Yeah, okay, cool. चेंज क्यों नहीं हो रहा है? लाइट चेंज नहीं हो रहा है. Then this is when after feedback I got a little more clear as to what we were doing, right? This gave a sense of this whole story that we were trying to create, obviously. So here, you know, this whole magic for beginners, he becomes a magician and then he grants their wishes. So sare jo uske disciples jo aate hain unke sare wishes ko grant kar raha ho. So he becomes a magician, so he's reading these magic books, you know, magic for beginners, all that kind of thing. So to satirize the whole thing, you know, to make mockery of these people who pretending to be godmen. he's you know, granting their wishes. He puts up this, the disciples put up all these beautiful posters of him on the back to, you know, kind of eulogize him, kind of pay tribute to him. And then, of course, he reads those 101 ways to con people. He reads that book, if you remember, he's reading that book. No, 101 ways to con people. And then other things, of course, that scene where he's playing the bansuri, and then the last where he's posing with these models, you know, all of that. Yeah, there are more, you know. चमत्कार कर रहा है वो ऐसे पॉइंट करता है और फिर कुछ अपीयर होता है वो ऐसे कुछ पॉइंट करता है फिर वो कुछ अपीयर होता है यू नो ऑल ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ फन देन ही इज डूइंग स्विशेस एंड दैट एंड देयर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दैट वी प्लानड यू नो व्हेन वी एक्चुअली वी वांटेड टू कीप दैट इंटरेस्टिंग वो ऐसा कन्वेंशनल नहीं होना चाहिए था या दैट्स बेसिकली देन यू नो ऑल द डिसिपल्स दैट कम इन एंड दे कम अराउंड हिम एंड देन दे सडनली बिकम गेट इनटू दीस रोब्स you know, somebody's wearing orange, somebody's wearing yellow, then there's this whole rules of spinism, right? If you remember, there's that poster that goes up and he creates his own rule book. Ki yaar, ye jo hai hamare religion ka tenets hai. Ki har religion ka ek holy book hota hai na, ye hamara holy book hai. Tum dekho abhi, ye rules hai, ye agar tum, agar ek tum spinism ko follow karte ho, to ye tumhe rules follow karne padenge, jo bhi hai. To wo sab jo cheeze hai, wo humne figure out kiye the us time pe. फिर ऑब्वियसली द आइडिया ऑफ दिस इज ऑल्सो दैट वो पैसे भी कमा रहा है वो जो जो भी कर रहा है ये उससे पैसे कमा रहा है वो तो पीपल आर कमिंग इन यू नो ऑल दी पीपल आर कमिंग इन दिस यू नो इनिशियली इट स्टार्ट्स ऑफ विद हिम वेयरिंग दिस वेरी डर्टी रोब तो कोई उसको पैसे नहीं देता बिकॉज ही ड्रेस्ड लाइक अ बेगर फिर वो ही जस्ट चेंजेस हिज क्लोथ्स यू नो ही जस्ट लुक्स लाइक अ बाबा एंड नाउ सडनली ही गेट्स सो मच ऑफ मनी इन हिज बोल एंड ही सीज अरे वाओ दिस इज really magic you know I just have to wear interesting clothes I just have to look like a baba and I'll just earn so much of money so he that's how it grows you know into becoming a whole religion it just starts off with his attire changing so yeah that's what it is yeah then we did a short breakdown this is interesting every film goes through it so we knew that you know when the policeman ka jab chase hoga us time pe there'll be the artwork we need to face so the artwork had to be symbolic of what is going on in his inner monologues उसके दिमाग में क्या चल रहा है वो ही उसका जो डिपिक्शन है वो मेटाफोरिकली वो आर्टवर्क पे दिखना चाहिए तो पुलिसमैन चेस विल बी व्हाटएवर आर्टवर्क देन द व्हेन ही एंटर्स द फ्रेम टायर्ड व्हाट आर द काइंड ऑफ आर्टवर्क दैट ही विल हैव देन व्हाट इज द आर्टवर्क दैट विल हैव व्हेन यू नो ही इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग सो देयर विल बी अ स्पेक्टिकल फ्रेम ऑन द आईज एंड देन द स्पेक्टिकल विल क्रैकल व्हेन ही गेट्स एन आईडिया एंड ही स्नैपिंग हिज फिंगर देयर्स अ क्रैकल दैट आर पॉपिंग इन द ग्रास फ्रेम And he's circling around the room in excitement. There are excitement crackers. So all of these things were planned out. You know, there was nothing that we had left on the post-production. In fact, we had made an entire booklet where we had sketched out all the artwork. So we had taken, we had shot the entire film with, you know, just a test shoot that we had done. We had made an entire storyboard, and on the storyboard we sketched out, you know, the artwork as well. कि ये इस फ्रेम पे ये होगा इस फ्रेम पे तो बस वो जो हमारा छोटे उस पे था बुकलेट में जो भी था That was the same thing that we replicated on the shoot, you know. We had planned out every little detail of it. And that's important. For a film like this, it cannot be done if it's not, you know, so well planned out. Then obviously, this was one of the variables that we were playing with is obviously jo uska jo movement hai, wo ek variable tha. Phir dusra variable ye tha ki, obviously artwork bhi change hoga. Abhi ek teesra variable maine introduce kiya usme. Ki jaise wo artwork bhi change ho raha hai, जैसे वो मूव भी कर रहा है लाइटिंग का भी फ्रेम बाय फ्रेम चेंज होगा फ्रेम बाय फ्रेम लाइटिंग भी चेंज होगा तो ऑब्वियसली उसके लिए मैंने एक ट्रीटमेंट नोट दिखा था दिस इज कॉल्ड ट्रीटमेंट नोट इज बेसिकली टू गिव अ सेंस ऑफ द ट्रीटमेंट और द विजुअलाइजेशन राइट सो व्हाट इज इट स्टार्ट विथ हाउ डज द लाइटिंग मूव डज द लाइटिंग ऑल्सो सो वी हैव टू पुट वी सेड ओके द लाइटिंग ओनली विल नॉट जस्ट चेंज द लाइटिंग का जो कलर है वो भी चेंज होगा So we would put translucent paper over it for different colors, you know. And lighting also doesn't, cinematography doesn't usually just include this. It also includes the grading. The grading is the color correction. You know, what is the kind of color? So that in post-production, we can also change the color in post. Right? On DaVinci Resolve or, you know, other softwares, Nuke. You can change the colors. You can change the... तो व्हाट इज द काइंड ऑफ कलर्स दैट सो वी न्यू दैट यू नो जब वो उसके ग्लासेस जो चेंज हो रहे हैं वो ऑब्वियसली वो थोड़ा सा साइकेडेलिक होना चाहिए या थोड़ा ट्रिपी होना चाहिए तो ऑब्वियसली उस पे जो कलर्स हमने जो डाले थे येलो ग्रीन ब्लू ऑरेंज रेड व्हाटएवर यू नो दे कीप चेंजिंग यू नो सो इट मेक्स इट लुक वेरी वेरी काइंड ऑफ साइकेडेलिक इन अ सेंस इट लुक्स लाइक यू नो ही इज हाई ऑन कोकेन और समथिंग देन Obviously, there's a, every film has a master breakdown that's made. Again, this is a production kind of thing. So what is the cast? By the way, Nakul, who is the main main kind of... Nakul, who played the main protagonist in the film, he was in Gully Boy last year. If you guys recognized him, he was in Gully Boy. He was Salman, he was Vijay Verma and Ranveer Singh's friend. But then this was all before he was even a star or anything. And so he was there, the cast, of course, then the passerbys jo the, baki ke jo religious disciples the, wo sab, main publishing house chala raha tha us time pe, aur wo sare mere interns the. Toh main, sare wo log aa gaye usme, phir mere friends aa gaye, main khud gaya ek shot mein, I don't think you'd recognize me, but I'm also there in the film. So all of that, you know, that's how we basically got the cast together. And of course, we did some rehearsals with the cast. Sorry? Okay. So we did some kind of rehearsals with the cast as well because I didn't want them, you know, to come fresh on set knowing not what they have to do. So we kind of did some kind of rehearsals with them and we did some briefing sessions and workshops and all with the other secondary actors also. And then obviously we created cutouts, you know, because we said, "Acha, jab agar let's say time nahi mila hume painting karne ke liye, to hum cutout chipka denge aur frame by frame wo cutout ko move karenge." फिजिक्स के ने उसकी हजार कटआउट बना लिए क्लाउड्स के बना लिए बाकी चीजें जो हमने बाकी बाद में यूज भी नहीं किया था बट हमने बना के रखे थे सब साइड में कि हम देखेंगे अगर यूज करना है यूज करेंगे नहीं यूज करना है तो रखेंगे वो छोड़ देंगे सो वी न्यू यू नो कि 100 फ्रेम्स फॉर 14 को 100 फ्रेम्स हम शूट करेंगे डे वन पे देन 86 फ्रेम्स तो एग्जैक्ट नंबर ऑफ फ्रेम्स जितने शूट करने थे उतना हमने प्लान भी किया था कि इतने फ्रेम्स हमें शूट करने ही है इस दिन में तो ऐसे हमने पूरा एक ब्रेकडाउन बनाया था फॉर ऑल द डेज देन दिस इज एनीवे रिक्वायरमेंट लिस्ट है तो कोई ज्यादा कुछ है नहीं इसमें बट बेसिकली पेंट के क्या रिक्वायरमेंट्स रहेंगे क्या बाकी रिक्वायरमेंट्स रहेंगे वो सब चीजें तो वो वॉल भी हमने बनाया था पहले पीछे वॉल था ना पीछे हमने बनाया था उनके लिए 7000 प्लस हैंड पेंटेड फ्रेम्स विजुअल काइंड ऑफ designers, artists, you know, a lot of people are working on pre-production, an entirely hand-painted film. That's me painting a frame, painting the eye. Yeah. And of course the shoot going on. Then because, you know, he had to hold for all those, you know, the while the painting is happening, usko position hold karna tha. So do log ya teen log usko sirf hold kar rahe the. Aur ek banda usko pani pila raha tha upar se. तो ये होल्ड करना ना सबसे मुश्किल काम तो यही था कि इसको पोजीशन में कैसे होल्ड करें फिर ये भी दीज आर ऑल माय स्कूल फ्रेंड्स यू नो ऑल माय जूनियर्स फ्रॉम स्कूल जूनियर्स फ्रॉम कॉलेज अदर प्लेसेस यू नो एंड ये पेंटिंग चल रहा है कार्ट का Then your painting पीछे background पे चल रहा है. Then you know all the people changing quickly paint because essentially it was not just about painting these frames. वो 10 मिनट उसको paint को dry करने के लिए भी रखना था हमें. दूसरे frame paint shoot करने के लिए, right? तो paint पहले paint करना एक चीज है और फिर उसको dry के लिए रखना भी दूसरी चीज है. तो वो काफी मतलब हर चीज जो हमें करना पड़ा वो एक it had to happen at a certain pace, you know, to in order to finish the film on time. तो वो सबसे मुश्किल काम था बट वी हैड वेरी गुड टीम यू नो सब लाइक आई यूज्ड टू से ओके मूव इन एवरीबॉडी यूज्ड टू रन इन क्विकली चेंज द फ्रेम चेंज पेंट व्हाटएवर चेंज द काइंड ऑफ कटआउट्स व्हाटएवर एंड देन रन बैक आउट सो दैट यू नो वी रेडी फॉर द नेक्स्ट शॉट तो सब काम अच्छे से हुआ thankfully. But it was quite stressful. Then that's me on the left hand side, basic lighting. That's me. So my shirt bhi pehen raha hu, there are all these religions, and there's my religion says peace is my religion. So that was also symbolic. Then I was giving feedback over email. So because I went back to college, so I studied at Ashoka University in Delhi. So while the post production was getting completed, I was giving feedback over email. So editor was asking me ki ye frame rakhna hai nahi rakhna hai. To kafi frames humne nikal diye the usme post edit mein. Kafi sequences humne nikal bhi diye the. Wo sab cheeze. Then it was screened. The first screening we had was at Kala Ghoda Festival in Mumbai. And this was the timeline. This was all the selections, you know, baki cheeze. Then this is Abid Surti, the film Abid, which was made. If you see the film, it's made on this painter called Abid Surti, and he's in the film as well. So he saw Religion for Dummies and he really liked it. So I met up with him, and if you can see, there are some, like, you see the left hand side, top left and top right. That's the visual reference and visual inspiration we got from Abid. The film, 1974 film that I was telling you about. So he saw the film and he really liked it, and he called me up and he even wrote a post on Facebook saying, you know, what a film and really nicely done and this, that and the other. So that was a great moment for me actually. So I just put it in this. Yeah, I guess we're done. I want to know if you guys have any questions. I have some more stuff to add as well, but I will add only after I get some questions from you guys.
So Kabir, I had a question.
Yeah.
So like, what is the amount of detail, or what is the threshold of the amount of detail you add to a scene? Because like too much detail would also create some issues, or too less detail would also. So what is the amount like? Is there any, like, how do you decide on it?
So everything is at the end of the day subservient to the story. Correct. वो सब story के हिसाब से होता है. अगर स्टोरी की रिक्वायरमेंट है कि हमारा जो प्रोडक्शन डिजाइन है वो मिनिमल होना चाहिए, तो फिर वो मिनिमल रहेगा. अगर ऑब्वियसली स्टोरी का रिक्वायरमेंट है, जैसे कि ये फिल्म जो थी, ऑब्वियसली इसका रिक्वायरमेंट यही था कि वो डिटेलिंग ज्यादा होनी चाहिए, बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली यू वी नीड टू ब्रिंग आउट द एग्जूबरेंस और द काइंड ऑफ ओवर द टॉपनेस ऑफ दीज गॉडमैन, राइट, विच इज वाई द कलर्स आर ऑल्सो फुल ब्लोन, यू नो, ऑल like completely hyper-saturated colors, hyper-saturated detailing, a lot of production design, lot of clutter and tamasha in the frame. So the film required that, you know, to get the kind of, it's called atmospherics. In cinematic language, it's called atmospherics. Atmospherics is basically the atmosphere or the world building that you're doing to create the kind of, to create that authenticity in the kind of story that you want to tell. Right? Cool. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, it does.
Okay, cool. Thanks. Anything else, guys? Any other questions?
So, hi Kabir. Yeah.
Hi.
How does a Janya? It's a little offbeat maybe, but how does a business model for such kind of short films work? You know.
So, sir.
In terms of its production, in terms of budgeting, in terms of, you know. Generally, as a revenue model, let's say if tomorrow somebody, because the short film is something that, let's say someday some of the students may want to get and engaged into making, you know, but they may not have any idea on how to really go about this. So,
sir, very frankly, unfortunately, short films don't have a market. So, uska recovery model hai nahi. But as far as kyun banate hain short films, hum short films isliye banate hain kyunki wo film fir visiting card ban jati hai. तो आप जाके दिखा सकते हो कि ये देखो हमारा पोर्टफोलियो है, हमने ये फिल्म बनाई है, और उससे ऑब्वियसली और काम मिलता है. सो दैट इज व्हाई आई मेड द फिल्म. एंड एज फार एज हाउ आई मेड द फिल्म विद व्हाट बजट्स, वी हैड अ टाई अप विद एशियन पेंट्स. तो वो पेंट्स का तो हमारा वहीं पे हो गया, कुछ 50-60 हज़ार रुपये का कॉस्ट वहीं पे कट गया. और बाकी के जो चीजें थी, ऑब्वियसली कटआउट वगैरह, वो तो पेटी कॉस्ट थे. वो तो आई वाज रनिंग अ पब्लिशिंग हाउस. आई एम नॉट जस्ट अ फिल्म मेकर, आई एम एन एंटरप्रेन्योर एज वेल. एंड आई वाज रनिंग अ पब्लिशिंग हाउस एट दैट पॉइंट. एंड हमने 11 कुछ बुक्स पब्लिश की थी, फिक्शन एंड नॉन फिक्शन. तो वो जो पैसा उसमें से कमाया हमने थोड़ा बहुत यहाँ पे लगाया, जो कैमरा यूज किया था वो मेरे दोस्त का था, बाकी के जो लोग आए थे वो मेरे सारे स्कूल फ्रेंड्स थे, कॉलेज फ्रेंड्स थे, वो मेरे सारे यार दोस्त थे, तो वो हो गया, फिर बन गई वो.
The fact is, in order to basically take an initiative, sometimes people plan too much, but not realizing that you have got a lot of resources around, you know, at this point.
Yeah, yeah. And the thing is, if you have a vision, if you know what you want to do, and you have references, and people can see that this, because the thing is, if I didn't have Abid, or if I didn't have Neighbours as a visual reference, then if I, even if I planned a film like this, nobody would be convinced. You know, they would say, "Yaar, tum kya baat karo?" Because ye film bhi explain karna bahut mushkil ho jata hai. तो मैंने क्या किया ना, जिस लोगों को कन्विंस करने के लिए मैंने पहले उनको फिल्म दिखाई थी ये दोनों, और बोला था ये ऐसे टाइप का करना है, बट ऑब्वियसली इसमें स्टोरी रहेगा और स्टोरी अलग रहेगा, और स्टोरी जो देन आई टोल्ड देम द स्टोरी एंड आई सेड ये ऐसे होगा और सीक्वेंस ऑफ इवेंट्स ये रहेंगे, और उस हिसाब से ऑब्वियसली लोग ऑब्वियसली समझ गए एंड दे आल्सो कन्विंस एंड दे सॉ द फिल्म यू नो इन सम वे इन द काइंड ऑफ ब्रीफिंग दैट आई गिव देम एंड दे सेड ओके वी वांट टू जॉइन इन एंड सी व्हाट हैपेंस. And I'm thankful because, you know, I think my personal philosophy is that films are made with conviction. So, you know, that conviction is required. That conviction is required to make any form of, any kind of film that you want to make. And without that conviction, you know, it's very difficult to kind of first onboard people. And it's difficult for you also to believe in yourself in the film that you're making.
I'm very happy you basically spoke about conviction, because in the last session only we actually basically talked about conviction, you know.
Oh, is it? Okay.
So as a designer, I told them that you need to be convinced. How do you even basically, let's say, do a presentation to a client if you don't believe in that idea? How would you make sure that somebody else would believe in that idea, you know?
Absolutely.
So the first thing is to have a conviction about your own self, you know. I'm very happy you spoke about that. But anyway, I'll leave the floor open to the students, you know, if they have any questions to ask. And
Hi, Kabir. I have a question.
Yeah.
So, hi. How's your study in architecture and your interest in art helps you in filmmaking, helps you come up with ideas?
So, I am primarily a visual thinker more than, I see my films in images. I don't see my films as a narrative or a dramatic narrative, really. I'm primarily inspired by pieces of art, paintings, primarily inspired by music. So obviously, and also, you know, I think that whole architecture education that I got, very brief one, but that kind of gave me a kind of a spatial understanding also. Right. So the reason I did it was because Mr. Gyan Koria, who made this film called Good Road, a Gujarati film, which got the National Award 2 years ago and also went official selection at the Oscars. In fact, he was the one who told me that, you know, Kabir, you must do, and he was the nephew of Charles Koria. Do you guys know Charles Koria? You all know Charles Koria, right? Yeah. So he was a nephew of Charles Koria, and he in fact told me that, Kabir, you know, and if you see his film, The Good Road, you kind of see the shots that he's taken, you know, all the, it's fabulous. He's got a great sense of space in his films. And I actually saw the film and I could tell that, you know, his understanding of angles, his understanding of composition, his understanding of the visual language was so strong because of his architecture kind of education that he'd got. I thought that I must do architecture as well. Right. So that is the reason I actually got into it. And I think, you know, a lot can be told through images than through words. I think the visual language is much stronger than. And therefore, visual literacy is extremely critically important. You know, we pay so much of attention to, in schools also, we pay so much of education to STEM, S-T-E-M. We don't give the visual arts any weightage, and that is really sad, I think. That is very sad. Because a lot can be communicated through images than through words. I think images are much stronger. Does that answer your question, or is that too abstract?
It does, actually.
Okay. Anybody else? Any other questions? Yeah, Aryan.
So I saw in your concept notes while you were like in the storyboards that you had drawn, you were drawing a grid on the box. I think you were composing a frame there. How do you go about it? Like, how do you go about the composition?
Yeah.
of the frame.
Which one?
This X, where you're trying to figure out the proportions.
What are you talking about?
जिधर वन लिखा है लेफ्ट पेज लेफ्ट लेफ्ट साइड पे
हाँ
सो हाउ डू यू लाइक कंपोज इट लाइक आई मीन हाउ डू यू फिगर आउट द कंपोजिशन दैट्स माय क्वेश्चन
हाउ डू यू फिगर आउट माय कंपोजिशन दिस वाज जस्ट सम रफ काइंड ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी हैड मेड एट द बिगिनिंग आई डोंट रियली रिमेंबर दिस वाज ऑफ कोर्स लाइक आई सेड 3-4 इयर्स अगो सो आई डोंट रियली रिमेंबर व्हाट द होल रेजन डेत्र ऑफ दिस स्केच वाज But as how I figure out my composition is, I think, there are many ways of composing a frame. I usually take references from other films. I usually look at the kind of compositions people have. You know, people that like a film like a King's Speech, for example, has broken all rules of third. Has broken. Do you guys know the rule of third? Everybody knows the rule of third. Rule of third, you all don't know. Okay, one second. I'll show you what rule of third is. This is what rule of third is. You can see my screen, right?
No.
You can't see my screen?
You can see
the power. Okay, one second. Now you can see.
Yeah.
This is what rule of third is. You place your subject in any one of these four points, and automatically it adds some life to your frame. But of course, there are films like King's The King's Speech, for example, that has broken the rule of third. So lots of films like this rule is not sacrosanct. You know, it's not. These rules are usually made to be broken. So you know the rule, and then you break it. But you must master the rule first. That is the primary rule. So yes, Aryan. Any other questions here? I can't hear you, Aryan. Can't hear you.
No.
Okay.
So I have a doubt.
Yeah.
How did you come up with this idea of making it in the same room and then cut and paste frames?
So I came up with this idea because, like I said, I had seen that 1974 Films Division film Abid. And that became my primary visual reference, right? But that film was a non-narrative film. That was a purely experimental film that was supposed to be made with M.F. Hussain, in fact, and was supposed to be a depiction of M.F. Hussain's work in this very trippy kind of psychedelic way. But then obviously M.F. Hussain wasn't available, and so they asked Mr. Abid Surti to do it. And Mr. Abid Surti's work is very pop art, okay, very pop art style of work he has, and the whole film looks therefore very, very much like his work itself. The film, the language of the film, the kind of edit pattern that the film has, and the music and everything else, actually adds, it also is a kind of a depiction of the pop art style of his work as well. And then, out of obviously his paint, you see the film, you'll know what I'm talking about. It's as trippy as his work, right? And that's basically how I got this whole idea. Like I said, I got this seed of an idea in the lift when I said Aryan, this film is it's on YouTube. You've seen it, Religion for Dummies. Oh, you're talking about Abid. Abid is also on YouTube. I'll send you a link, Aryan. So it's a 1974 film called Abid, A-B-I-D, Abid. And I was saying that basically that's how I got the idea. I was in lift and I was, going up, and I said, why not make a film on a dummy's guide to start your own religion and make a mockumentary or a satire on that, right? So that was how it came about. And then, obviously I thought of the style, right? Which is the style that I would be able to communicate this idea. And then obviously it snapped, and I said, okay, why not do it like Abid, or why not do it like Norman McLaren's film, which is Neighbors, which you guys have seen. right? So that's how it happened. It was an amalgamation of both these films that became my reference for Religion for Dummies. Any other questions, guys? We have 5 minutes more.
Hi, Kabir.
Hi.
Hi. So when I was whenever I think about filmmaking, the idea of set designing really fascinates me. So I like what kind of skills or what kind of imagination goes into creating like the spaces for any film?
What kind of I think like I said, I was speaking about atmospherics. Everything is subservient to the story. Everything is story, story, story. Story comes first. And obviously, your set design comes after understanding the story to the depth that it needs to be understood, right? So you know your color palette, whether it will be pastel shades or whether you're looking at a more saturated color palette, or you're looking at what are the kind of textures you want to have in your frame, that will all come in through the kind of the character's journey in the story, and that will all, I'm speaking in a more abstract sense. Right? It will all come in through the understanding of the characters, characterization, or understanding. So, like if therefore for this film, I'll give you an idea of how we worked out the whole set design, the color palette rather. The idea was that obviously when as he's beginning, right, he's now this beggar who is who's put his bowl out and he's not able to get enough money from all of these passerbys. Right, and that's when he is in in the background. Also, we thought we will have pastel colors, and as his attire changes, as he becomes more exuberant, as he becomes more like this farcical godman that he becomes at the end of the film, which is much like a Ram Rahim or something. By that time, the pastel shades will become more saturated and then hypersaturated. Right, so the elements will keep adding in; they will all keep coming in as the film progresses. It doesn't start off with a bang. It starts off, it gradually gets there. For example, for this film, then I made a film called Karma Cafe, then the process there was also very different, So there to add more metaphor and to add more character and symbolism to the set, because that film was a more philosophical treatise, we added more mirrors in the frame. So the name of the character is also Darpan. Darpan means mirror, right? And it was supposed to be a reflection of this, the main protagonist, and where he's kind of reflecting on his karma. Right, to get that final perfect bowl of soup. I don't know whether you all have seen the film, but the film is about how he kind of has to open up and kind of come, he has to, repent in order to redeem himself, right, in the eyes of Darpan or in the eyes of the mirror, right? So in the kind of symbolism that we wanted in the set, we knew that we had to have these mirrors also. Like, so then the film, you'll see there are some shots where there are some mirrors. And obviously the kind of location we chose, the set, the cafe that we chose to shoot the film in, right? That also had a lot of character, So I knew that it had to have that, a sort of a mix of it had to be very contemporary, yet at the same time, it had to look very kind of Iranian in its look and its kind of appeal. So that was the way I chose. So I had a kind of a vision in my mind, and I said, okay, this type of set we need, and I made references. Nikale, yar, is tarika ka dhundo. Aur fir humne ye humne scout kiya locations ko dekha, humne baaki cheeze rekhi kiya. Fir we locked down on one location, which became the location of the film. And then obviously for the other films also, we had different processes. So there's not one way, but another thing to keep in mind for any kind of production design is. Or set design rather, is that a lot of set design is also about the blocking and the kind of shots that you take. So that visually yaar agar ek negative space dikh raha hai frame mein, to usko fill up karna chahiye. To har frame jo hai wo ek picture postcard jaise dikhna chahiye. Shot hume jama ke lena padta hai. Har frame jo hai jama ke lena padta hai. To agar lagta hai ki yaar ye frame mein na agar ek protagonist baitha raha hai. राइट ऑफ फ्रेम में और लेफ्ट ऑफ फ्रेम थोड़ा खाली लग रहा है तो वो शॉट में या तो पेंटिंग डाल देंगे या चेयर डाल देंगे कुछ एलिमेंट डाल देंगे फिर बाकी चीजें फोरग्राउंड में डालेंगे जस्ट टू गिव इट मोर कैरेक्टर द फ्रेम डज इट आंसर योर क्वेश्चन देयर आर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स इन दिस दिस इज नॉट अ स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड आंसर दिस इज अ वेरी एलैबोरेट आंसर बट जस्ट टू गिव यू अ ब्रॉड ब्रश स्ट्रोक ऑफ हाउ इट वर्क्स
या दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग
ओके ओके गुड थैंक यू चलो एनीथिंग एल्स गाइस.
So I have one last question.
Yeah.
So so your topics are very different, and they're not cliche. So when an audience, a public audience, sees this, most of them won't accept it. Or how do you convince them, or how do you make them accept this kind of different kind of works, which is not cliche?
वो मेरा काम नहीं है actually, very honestly वो मेरा काम नहीं है. मैं जो फिल्म का यही है मकसद कि फिल्म जो बनाते हो ना वो पर्सनल होना चाहिए. अगर फिल्म पर्सनल नहीं है, यू आर नॉट एन आर्टिस्ट विद इंटेग्रिटी. फिल्म ऑडियंस के लिए बना रहे हो, विच इज नॉट समथिंग यू नेसेसरली वॉन्ट टू मेक, विच इज नॉट समथिंग दैट इज पर्सनल टू यू, एंड वॉट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ दैट आर्ट? एंड इट्स अ प्रोडक्ट ना, इट्स नॉट अ फिल्म.
Okay.
तुम प्रोडक्ट बना रहे हो, फिल्म नहीं बना रहे हो.
बट एट सम पॉइंट आफ्टर यू हैव पुट इन सो मच एफर्ट, एट सम पॉइंट इट डज अफेक्ट यू ना, दैट पीपल शुड लाइक इट एंड डोंट क्रिटिसाइज इट.
दैट कम्स ऑटोमेटिकली. क्रिटिसिज्म एंड ऑल आई लाइक, इन फैक्ट वेरी ऑनेस्टली आई लाइक क्रिटिसिज्म, बट फॉर पीपल टू लाइक इट दैट कम्स ऑटोमेटिकली, यू नो, दैट कम्स ऑटोमेटिकली व्हेन यू आर ट्रू टू योरसेल्फ, नो, व्हेन यू आर ट्रू टू योर आर्ट. People will relate to your film because they know, yaar, ye film mein, there's an authenticity to it. It's real because it's drawn by your own personal experiences. So people can relate to it because people, everybody in some way or the other is similar, right? In this world, we're all human beings. We all have human emotions. So if you are depicting your emotions on screen, then other people can, there will be some audience that will be able to relate to your emotions. It becomes more authentic. It becomes more genuine, you know. It doesn't become like ingenuous, or it doesn't become like a flight in imagination. It becomes real. Any other questions, guys?
So I saw the making of Dali, where you shot in a green screen room, right? So there is no background there. There is no space there. Then how do you convince the actor, and how do you, like, you might have a very strong sense of visualization where there is nothing there, but you can see it, right? Like the background is not there, but how do you like picture that? And
when you're making a film against chroma, when you're making a VFX film, usually you have to have a storyboard, because otherwise nobody in your crew will really understand what you're doing. So you can't make a film like that if you don't have a storyboard. The actors don't know what they have to perform. You don't know what you're making. Forget you. The crew is not clear also what they're really shooting. So to get everybody on board, you have to have a storyboard, and the storyboard must have obviously what your character is doing in that shot, what is your framing like. Everything has to be perfect to the T, right? And what is the background that obviously the chroma will be replaced with? What is the world that you're creating around the character? You know, what is the world that is going to be created in CG? Which has to be very clear in CG is computer graphics for you, those of you who don't know. Okay. Yeah, I guess. Anything else, guys?
I think so. That's pretty fine. Thanks a lot, Kabir. It was just kind of quite great to have you on board. And especially largely focus on 3-4 aspects. You know, one is that the visual aspect becomes one of the very important aspects. You know, generally, when you work with anything, and largely any creative field, the visual aspect becomes one of the very important one. Two, to have some kind of basically a reference point or a role model or somewhere, you know, where basically it becomes a reference for you to kind of take a jump start and, you know, go about it, you know. And three is to have a conviction, you know, in the kind of the work that you are basically doing. So I was kind of quite happy that, you know, you basically touched upon this aspect at this point.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot for coming on board.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me.
We will keep you, and we'll keep in touch with you basically with whatever that comes out, you know, as final output. We'll let you know, you know, so that we'll share what are the work the students have done. We'll do that.
Please do that. I would love to see. Thank you so much for having me, guys. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining this session. And thanks for having me, Kamna and Jaisa.
Thank you, Kabir.
Thank you. I hope it was insightful. I hope somewhere it kind of added some value. Yeah.
It did, for sure.
It did, definitely.
Thank you. Okay. Yeah, I think we're good.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Thank you, Kabir.
Bye.
Guys, I will connect with you, not on this, but another platform.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I want to speak to you and then we can connect.
With this. Okay. Yes, yeah? Yes.